This is a poem inspired by Flann O'Brien's The Third Policeman, called Is It About a Bicycle? Is it about a bicycle, says he. I suppose it is, says I. He was this old guy that used to fix them, bore the look of a haunted man, face all pale and wan, hands stained with oil and nicotine, mustache and hair mainly with the latter, but with him accepting cigarettes as collateral, or rather cheapskate parents pushing them upon him. A puncture fixed for a packet of fags. Sure, he could have doubled up with a nicotine patch, one for the puncture and one for himself, but some men pay no heed to the highway to health because they're on another road altogether. If you know the story, you'll know the road. If you don't, you'll find out soon enough. Now this man, we'll call him Tommy, because that was his name. He had a room full of busted television sets. It was full from floor to ceiling. You could see them past the dirty net curtains, through the vase with a single rancid flower. Christ knows what he planned to do with them all. And I've been thinking more and more about this fella, how isolated he appeared to be, the loneliness hanging off him like a sorrow-scented magic tree, and you might say that's another mode of transport altogether, and you'd be right, but it's not the point. He was holed up in that bungalow with everything broken, and the only time he opened the door was to welcome yet more broken stuff. And then there was all the village whispers, the wildest rumours you ever heard. They said that per capita, the number of children's broken bikes in our area was way too high, and all elbows pointed at Tommy like he had some agenda beyond the hoarding of cigarettes and busted television sets. They said he was using the parts of those to build himself a time machine. Word was he wanted to undo some deed from his past. Everyone would sit around and laugh, speculating what it could be. But none of them were as bad as me the day I approached his door and asked him to fix a flat tire on my imaginary BMX. Tommy ticking off and on the specs, trying to see where it was. My friends behind the wall holding back the laughs. And as soon as he asked, a chorus erupted. A barrage of howls, finger pointing and insults. Tommy's yellow hands might have went round my throat, but it was only himself that he choked. There wasn't another piece of business put his way. Eventually, he hounded out of town, leaving behind his bicycle pumps, tire tubes, and other bits of junk. And you know, sometimes I dream that I've found a way to redeem myself. In it, I'm me as a child approaching his door apprehensively, and a single white lily blooms in the vase, and when Tommy appears, he's got the look of a young man. No nicotine-stained hair or hands, just a faint, reassuring smell of oil. Is it about a bicycle, he says. I suppose it is, I reply.